Understand? Yeah, but that's why I'm a little bit nervous, but I can say what
Me too, I am nervous. Me too.
yeah.
The same thing.
I know I don't like to talk
Okay,
too much.
so who wants to? Okay, so Susan, you're ready, right?
I'm ready since
okay. Now
I've seen
you
John
please
Pussy
start, Susan, because
myself playing.
the recording has started. So Susan, please start.
Okay, my name is Susan Songe. I chose to talk about the challenging learning online. First of all, the learning online didn't start now. Since some people, some schools already giving some courses online, but because of the pandemic now, it became like a universe. So everybody learning online, shopping online. So the difficult, the challenging is some of family didn't have the computer when the confinement started. So they were panicking, saying that where can I find all the store are closed, and then they don't know how to shop online. So that's one of the challenge they have. So after a while, other challenging is like the internet, how to log in, how to make sure the connection is good. So a lot of people has that problem, that challenge. Even me, when I started learning online was in the summer. I take one summer course, and then it was online. I had a lot of challenges. Had to log in, had to go on my Google class. Sometimes the internet was not working. Oh my God, why did I take this English class? But I said, okay, I have to make it. And then after a while, I overcome the difficulties. And then I have to talk also about the benefit. The benefit is that the student, any student, adult, young, they have experience with online learning. They can even learn with a book open, surface somewhere, grammar, vocabulary online when they are in the class. That's the benefit. And then they cannot go out and play with friends, so they're focusing on learning classes. And then everybody's at home, that's the benefit. So you see all the children at home, everybody focusing on the computer, working, studying. Even though sometimes the phone will ring to disturb a little bit, but they can still come on the track to continue. Even the parents that they didn't know how to use the computer. Some parents did not even know that the computer exists. But because of the pandemic, yeah, that's the benefit. Because of the pandemic, everybody now, even in my village, people know that the computer exists. Understand? So at the same time, this pandemic gives some benefit to us and some challenges, because some people didn't know how even to log in, how to open the computer, how to save the document. So I mixed everything at the same time, the challenges and the benefits. So
And you try to focus on the benefits, right?
I hope everything that I say is good.
Yes.
I'm
Yeah.
stuck.
Are you ready for the questions?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay. Let me just change my layout. Okay. Everybody, question for Suzanne. Her name is Suzanne. Okay, Shani.
Congratulations, Suzanne. I'm very happy for you. You've done a great job. So, I have a question for you. May I ask you?
Of course.
So, Suzanne, now you are able, do you able to overcome of the difficulties of online learning now?
Yeah, I can use the computer easily. to get in the Google class easily, but before I had a lot of challenges. I had to call my children. How can I see people on my Google class? Where do they know? I had to go use their homework. I'm late and this and that, understand? Now I'm on the track.
Okay.
Good. So then that's a good part of online learning.
Yeah. Even I can shop online now. I didn't know before.
No, really. Now, what Ying said, right? That this pandemic has really allowed us to learn better knowledge of technology. If we focus on what we learned instead of what we lost, then we will feel more comfortable, right? Like sometimes things happen for a reason, and sometimes some things are blessings in disguise. You understand blessings in disguise? A blessing in disguise.
I understand blessing, but I don't understand disguise.
Okay, no. It's an expression, Suzanne. When you say it's a blessing in disguise, means
blessing in disguise.
It means when you look at it for the first time, it's very negative. It's negative, but because of this negativity, it's like a test to make you grow better as a person. Okay? So this pandemic, we can say that it's a blessing in disguise because it made our families closer, hopefully, and it made us more abreast with news and technology, and it made us it actually empowered some students. I have students in the past that because of online learning, they become more confident than going to school, which is, a little bit surprising because for me, confidence, you can earn it more mostly in-person interaction. Right?
Yeah. I prefer in-person.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, I know Suzanne. Okay, so next question for Suzanne. Amarjit, are you asking or presenting?
Yeah, her presentation was very good.
Okay.
I just want to comment on
her. Wonderful. Okay, Amarjit.
I'm also ready to go after that. It's Manas.
Okay, so after Amarjit, Manas, you're next. Okay, Amarjit, please, are you ready? Okay, you're next. Suzanne, thank you so much. By the way, you're very spontaneous, Suzanne, when you were presenting. And, I'm going to talk to you about this, like how you can improve your pronunciation.
Yeah.
And make it, smoother, right? Yeah, because I know you're fluent, but your pronunciation sometimes impedes the comprehension of other people, right? Okay,
yeah.
But I'm going to give you more. Suzanne, you need to socialize more. If you're... Okay, so anyway. Amarjit.
Okay, thank you.
Amarjit, go.
Yeah.
Amarjit, you have no sound.
Yes, I have. It's on.
Okay, so.
The microphone is on.
Mm-hmm.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. I want to go to the first one, but somebody came to fix my kitchen. That's why I couldn't go fast. now he left. Yeah. Can I start?
Yeah, you start.
Yeah. Okay. Hi, everyone. My name is Amarjit. I would like to present about what challenge I face in this country when I came to Canada. I was 19 year old when I came to Canada, right? So when after two, three months, I got my work permit, right? I came as a visitor. So after 2-3 months, I got my work permit. Then I started working, right? But I didn't check the
the weather was kind of like, the weather wasn't like now. It was very cold that time. It's the cold start in September, May, in 40 year ago. Now is global warming. The weather change, everything is changed. So that's why I got up morning time and drank my tea, pack up my lunch and went out. That time we were living in apartment. So when I went out, there was black ice. I was wearing my India shoes, right? So when I went out, I fell down, right? On the ice. Then I got up again, then I fell down again. I was thinking, what's going on, right? Then I crawled like a baby, then on the grass, then I took the bus, then I went to the work. The second day, I don't know, they asked me for work Good Friday, right? So I didn't know the bus service start at 10 o'clock. I just regular time on the bus stop 6:30. I went to the bus stop 6:30. I waited until 10 o'clock. The bus came 10 o'clock. I stood 3.5 hours in the bus stop. There was no bench to sit, nothing. That time I was young, that's why I could survive. So the other thing, I started working in the plastic company, right? So my uncle was a supervisor there. Then the afternoon shift supervisor jealous with us because my uncle, he has an engine shop in India. He knows how to fix the machines, right? He doesn't know anything. So that the plastic cup was, we were making plastic cup there, foam cups, which we drank coffee and tea and water. So the afternoon shift, they pack cups. There is no bottom, the cups, right? And his wife took in the office and show the manager, right? And manager called me and my friend in the office. He said, what you did this? I don't know English. So I didn't say anything to him. He said, we just be quiet, right? We didn't say anything to him. That means I have English barrier, right? You guys are good. You should learn the English, I'm telling you. I didn't learn. That's why I faced these problems, right? Now I am learning, I'm very happy. I do my things my own. I go to the doctor my own. I went to the hospital my own. So I am very happy. I am very appreciative, Andrew, who taught me these things, right? So all the teacher I appreciate very much. So that's it. Do you have any question to ask?
Please? Any question for Amarjit?
Your conversation is very interesting. It's so nice.
Thank you.
You know, yeah, it's very natural.
Yeah, okay. Because that time, no people, no, I never heard these kind of classes I can join. Okay. Now everybody knows these kind of classes we can join. That time, I never heard I could join that time. And no other people, no, not that community that matches. You know, when I went to we went to the Kmart, only 2-3 people in the store. The store was empty. Okay. No population that time.
Which year was that?
1977.
Oh my God, 1977! I was so young.
This tiny Indian people. I got so happy and I got so
I was
excited.
So young. I was so young and so cute in 1977. Okay, everybody, can please, okay, Manas, you're next, but everybody, Fahad, Samuel, Samuel, Amirold, Afshin, Mona, you have to ask a question. You cannot just come to the class and turn off your camera and watch people, you know? You've got to show the teacher that you're able to contribute. You know what I mean? Yes, please.
Sir, can I ask a question?
Who's Margaret? This?
Yes.
Okay, who's yeah. This?
Al-Shaima.
Okay, Al-Shaima. Okay, go.
Yeah. Thank you, Margaret, for your sharing this interesting experience. But you mentioned that the weather in Canada were different 19 years ago. You mentioned that?
No, I'm talking about 43 years ago.
It was different?
But 43 years ago, but the weather was very cold that time, not like now. The global warming, very cold. It's a stop, the winter start in September, finish in April.
Okay, Al-Shaima, wait. Yeah. Al-Shaima, why were you asking about this? Do you have a question?
Yes, because I think that global warming make it worse, not better. But for Margarita, Amjad, she said the weather became more better than before.
Yeah, that's what she said. She said
more warm. I am saying more warm. That time was very cold weather.
Really? So, yeah. So.
No, it can also.
One day is minus 15. The second day is minus 1. Like that. That day was 2-3 weeks straight cold. Minus 35, minus 40. One day it was minus 40, nobody couldn't start their cars.
Oh.
If I talked to my brother-in-law, he said I couldn't start. And my other brother, we couldn't start.
Yeah.
We had to lock the car inside.
I am asking these questions because I believe that it became worse. Worse than before, not better. That's why I get confused.
Yeah, okay. Yes, and also, just for the benefit of the doubt, it could also be, but because you mentioned about the temperature, right? It could also be like when you are new in Canada, coming from a tropical country, it's colder for you. But after 10 years, 15 years, your body is well adjusted, so you imagine psychologically you think that it's warmer. Yeah, you know. But because Amarjit said it was minus 17, minus 18 before, but right now it's like minus 18, minus 20 it rarely happens. Okay? And maybe it's the result of global warming. Okay, so Susan, you wanted to ask a question?
Me. No, I raised my hand before.
Okay. So, Osap, who's that? Osap, you wanted to ask a question?
Yes.
Make it short, okay? Because we're, okay. Because
you've
been practicing since this morning. Okay, Osap, because I know your voice is beautiful.
You said that you didn't know about when you came in. So no one's live over here to make you understand or to teach you or to tell you that about our bus timing, about the weather, what you have to wear in. I came in over here, so my family recommended me, wearing a slipper. We have to wear our shoes, which one is not slip.
Yeah.
So no one's with you at that time?
No, they didn't tell me anything.
No, really?
If I knew why I go there,
it means they were going to revenge with you.
I'm talking about Good Friday. Everybody refused to work, right? That time I don't know English. I don't.
No, Amarjit, you were lucky.
I said, okay, because I need money.
Amarjit, listen.
Why is no shoes?
Amarjit and Osap, you are lucky that nobody told you, right? Because listen, listen to this. Yeah, I know somebody told you also. Listen to this. When I was new in Canada, I was like, I came in 1992, and I married a Vietnamese lady. And when I said I wanted to take a shower, you know, she told me, oh, okay, let me teach you how to mix the hot water and the cold water. Yeah. And then I look at my wife, I said, excuse me, I'm from the U.S. But yeah, she looked at me, she thought that I didn't know how to mix the hot water and the cold water.
Yeah.
Mama mia, I was shocked, you know. And he said, oh, yeah, I forgot. He said, because I met you in Asia, she told me. Oh, my God. Okay, we're going to, okay, everybody.
Before
here we go.
I wanted to say congratulations to Amarjit. And I admire you so much, Amarjit. You don't know how. It's just, I see you.
Yeah.
And I can see my mom.
Yes.
Doing the same, because after she get retired, well, she find a purpose in her life. So she learned how to use a computer. She
yes.
took classes, and
yes.
then she goes somewhere. And my husband gave her a phone, because in my country the technology is just coming really, really low. Slow. So we got a phone like 3 or 4 years ago. And now my mom, she's able to call me, doing WhatsApp and Facebook,
yeah.
social media. So I see you, and I can only, you can only remind my mom. To me, it's just come to my mind, and I'm so happy for you guys. And that's what, you know, old people, when they think, oh, you got all, and then just, you know,
yeah.
stay in the home, doing the, you know, the household chores, or, you know, or going to the market. No, you should do this. And you are an example for everyone that you can do everything. It doesn't matter if you're 25 or 60. Just
yes.
you can't stop learning.
Yes.
yes.
During the
pandemic, I learned about the computer so much.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Amarjit. Okay, let me just talk to everybody. If you have older parents living with you, don't always like think that, oh, they don't need technology. You know, you should teach them. You should buy them a computer or a laptop.
Yes.
Buy them a computer or a laptop and teach them how to talk online with their grandchildren back home. So they will
yes.
they will, you know,
yes.
so they will grow old like seeing
yes.
the grandchildren. You know, like
yes.
our parents, normally they don't wanna bother us. They don't want to complain. They just like sit there. But, you know, if we children volunteer to do this for them, then you will see they will be very happy. They will grow old knowing that they still have a comfortable and real life. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Yes.
So if you want to give your parents or your grandparents a gift, buy them a laptop and teach them
yes.
how to communicate back home using a camera like YouTube, what was this? Facebook, yeah, you know, or you do you know that you can also install Google Classroom on your computer, and then talk with your parents back home, but
yeah.
yes, you can, but you are limited to I think 5 people, or 3. You can also install Zoom, and you get it for free, but you can only invite 4 people.
Yes.
Okay, so yes, like I hope that you will follow my advice, because you know, like, and it's not funny, Neri, because my aunt, like 100% American, my aunt is 100% American, living in California, she does not know how to use technology.
Yeah.
I said to her, Auntie, can you please like turn on your WhatsApp? And she said to me, what is WhatsApp? Yes, she told me. She said, I don't. She said to me, I don't. She said to me,
my laptop, my tablet, my iPad, they bought me everything. My kid.
Yes, my aunt told me, I don't want to install this. Who will help me install this? So the, you know what? That's why I cannot call, I cannot talk to her all the time because it's too expensive for me. You know, I have to call her on a regular phone. And sometimes I have to buy like a phone card. You know, I have to buy a phone card and to call her. And when I finish calling her, I spend $5. Yeah, but WhatsApp is free. You know what I mean? Okay, Manas, your turn. Manas.
Yes, please. Can you
Okay.
guys hear me?
Yes. Okay.
Yes, okay. Thank you so much. Hi, my name is Manas, and today my topic is also I'm presenting on challenges of learning online. As like my other class fellow already presented on this, and they all had great points. I also feel that
Wow.
due to current situations, it is a great topic, and it's very relevant topic for these days, so to present on this. So before I move on to challenges, I would say that there are always a great benefit of any new change comes into our life as well, same as learning online. And I can say that with new things I've learned, that it's going to be blessing in
These
disguise
guys.
as well. Like we can save time, energy, and expense on fuel and your clothing, as well as you can learn great self-discipline skills while learning online. So now let me talk about the challenges. First and most important challenge which I feel due to this change is adaptability struggle. So switching from traditional classroom to face-to-face learning from instructor to virtual classroom is a very different experience than normal, and it normally it is a human nature that they're resistant to adapt the change, so that's make little too difficult for initially to start learning online. Once you overcome with this, you can start learning different part of online learning. Next challenge which I feel that we are missing personal interaction and teamwork. When we go in person to the class, then we make friends and also not only learn quickly but also know each other very well, and we can help each other during our, if we have any questions which we miss during the class, then we can ask during our breaks and when while we are walking going back to home, so our classmate can help us, which make our learning experience much more faster and better than learning online when but if I have to wait for my time to ask question. Also, once class is over, we just turn off our camera and we will move over. So this is a biggest challenge and a part of the life that we are missing, that personal interaction and teamwork, that you can work as a team as well. So next challenge which I'm going to discuss is technical issues. So as many people and on Mariam, I think she also presented and talk about that many students may not have strong internet to learn online courses, and they are failed to catch up their classmates. So this is much challenging for the people that you have to have strong internet. For me as well, like I'm not able. I decided not to present between 9 to 10 just because my family is. This is my family's breakfast time, and when they have to turn on, they have to use microwave. And whenever they use microwave, my internet gets disconnected. So that's why I decided not to present. This is another tech. Yeah, this is a technical issue because maybe my internet is not that strong enough or what have you. These are the challenges. So next challenge would be computer literacy. So for new generation, which they are having computers, start learning from the beginning, from grade one, is may not be that a challenge. But for people that like us, that we always used to learn with paper, pen in our school, and we see computer after we come to the working environment. So this is at least not that much tech savvy. And it is a major issue amongst more on adult students than as compared to young generation. Next challenge, which I am going to talk about, time management. This is a very difficult task for online learner because this courses and anything you learn online is very require a lot of time and lots of hard work. also it could easy for young generation to manage their time because they have may have less responsibilities, but it will be more challenging on managing for adult people, like they, when they have multiple responsibilities. I have to work on my work as well as to know, I know that, okay, this is now my family breakfast time, as well as I have to keep in mind that, okay, I have to cook as well. So the time management is something what it's very hard to decide, okay, do I have to focus right now on learning or should I have to get up and now start cooking for my family or cooking some, or a guest coming to your home, so you have to get ready and you have to put your schoolwork or your learning time on the side. So last but not least would be self-motivation. So only a positive attitude will help you to overcome for this challenge, because it is hard to practice, and everyone has to understand that it is necessary to understand the benefit of e-learning or online learning, because everyone should know now that this is the future. No matter what, that this is going to be. It's not when pandemic will be over. We may go back to normal life, but now everyone knows that how much is beneficial is this. So, and time consuming and time saving and money saving, and it's probably once we all adapt this change, this will be much more benefit as compared to going in school in person. So this is a future. So we have to motivate ourselves and make sure now we manage our time and learn much quicker and accept this change and start working and learning according to this change. So that is all from me about the challenges of e-learning. So do you, anyone have any questions, please?
May I ask a question?
Okay, Medina, go ahead.
Yes, please.
Hi, Nana. My question is, what do you think advantage of learning online is more than disadvantage or no?
Currently, as it's not very new now, most of the stuff, but once we will overcome with all these challenges, needs to know how to connect, how to upload and download files, how quickly to go and learn. So once we learn all these tech savvy challenges or all those, I believe that online learning will be more beneficial, because we have, like, for same example, like shopping. Before, we have to spend days to go and different stores to shop around. Now, within 2 hours, I can shop 50 stores. And shop around. So at the same thing for the e-learning, because now we have to go to the school and sit there, and you have limited time to learn. Now you have unlimited time while you are learning online. You can learn and you can schedule your time your own. It says flexibility. So you can learn evening. If you have time in the evening, you can go and start learning. Mm-hmm. I can feel that eventually in future, this will be the this will